Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add React Color Picker to it. Using the Color Picker component, you can find and pick the perfect color using its various color specifications like RGB, HSV, or hex codes. Pick the color either by selecting from the color values or by adjusting hue and opacity values. In this video, you will see how to configure the Color Picker component with different types of modes and other customizations. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the Color Picker component, I type the npm install. At Syncfusion /ej2-react-inputs --save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. From 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the React Color Picker component from the Syncfusion ej2 React Inputs package and add the division element tag with the ID wrapper. Inside this tag, I add the h4 header tag to specify the label for the Color Picker component as choose a color and add the Color Picker component tag. Next, I need to define the CSS. I can either import the React Color Picker component CSS from the static assets file or refer the CDN link in the index.html file. To make it simple, I'm going to refer the CDN link, so let me open the index.html file and refer the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. Also, I add the text align style for the ID wrapper. Let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. See, the Color Picker component is displayed. When I click the down arrow button, you can see the pop-up showing different colors. From here, you can switch to the palette mode by just clicking the mode switcher and then pick the colors you need. Next, I will show you how to display a specific color on initial load because, by default, it is green. To change the color, I need to use the value property which accepts 3 or 6 digit hex color code. Now, I define the value property and set 4-digit hex code to it. In this color code, the last digit represents opacity. See now, the color specified in the value property is set to be selected by default. Next, I will show you the different types of modes. By default, the picker mode is shown on initial load, but you can also set palette or inline mode. To load the palette mode on initial rendering, simply set the mode property to palette. See the color picker now, it is rendered with the palette mode. As I said like before, you can also use the inline mode apart from these two modes. Now, to render the palette without the down arrow button, I add the inline property and set its value to true. See, the palette mode is rendered on initial load without a down arrow button. By default, you can switch to other modes in the color picker. To hide the mode switcher, set the mode switcher property to false. See, the color picker rendered without the mode switcher. Next, notice here, the apply and cancel buttons are shown in the color picker. If I want to hide the control buttons, I simply set the show buttons property to false. Now, the color picker component renders without any buttons. Next, I will show you how to add the no color tile to the color palette. Here, I want the first tile to render without any color. So, I add the no color property and set it to true. See, the first tile has no color. By default, the palette is rendered with a default set of colors. I can also load custom colors into the palette by specifying a set of colors using the preset colors property. First, I declare an object, color picker presets, and add a set of custom colors inside the custom field. Now, I assign this object to the preset colors property. As I am going to add 4 columns to the palette, I set the columns property to 4. Looking here, the palette displays the specified custom colors. Next, moving on to how to apply a selected color from the palette to a division element, I add the division element and set the ID as preview. Here, I plan to apply colors chosen from the palette, so add the event handler on color change to the change event. I define this method which receives the argument of type color picker event args. To access the color picker event args, it is necessary to import it from the EJ2 React Inputs package. Now, declare the state variable color and its corresponding state setter function set background color using the useState hook. Initialize the value of the color state with a custom color code. To access the useState hook in this application, it is necessary to import it from the React library. Inside this event handler, update the color state by invoking the set background color function and setting it to the hex value obtained from args current value hex. To apply the selected color to the division element, add the style attribute within this division tag and set its background color style property using the color state variable. Then, I define height, width, and margin styles for the division element in the app CSS file. See, when I select any color value from the color picker, it is applied to the division element. Now, I will show you how to hide the input area in the picker mode. For clarity, I will remove all the customizations done so far. To hide the input area, I need to add the CSS class property and set it to eHideValue. See, the picker mode is rendered without the input area. Finally, I will show you how to disable the color picker component using the disabled property. I remove the existing property and add the disabled property. See now, the color picker component is in a disabled state. In this video, I have shown you how to add the color picker component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like different types of color picker modes and other customizations. If you would like to see the working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.